What are you doing out here?
Challenging you to a game of Summoner's Court. I think it's time you faced a real opponent, outside of Ronan's little lesson in charms class. Summoner's Court isn't just a game. It's a battle of a test of a witch or wizard's mettle. What say?
I'm in. Let's do it.
Brilliant! Summoner's Court, the ever-changing game. Akia. Try to beat that. That was one for the ages. Akia. Nothing to it. I've seen worse. Come on, Leander. Ugh. Not bad. Not bad. Wait, did I win? I won! We should have bet a few galleons on that round. Care to go again?
I'm game for another round.
Grand! You could use the practice. Summoner's Court, the ever-changing game. All in the wrist. Missed the mark a bit on that one. Try to beat that. That was one for the ages. Akia. Nothing to it. You're not bad at this. Well done. You beat me. Bit of good luck, that's all.
I'm not lucky. I'm simply better than you.
All right, fine. You're right. You're better than me. I'll let the others know you're good enough to keep playing.
The others?
I lost 7 matches in a row to Samantha Dale. The others who play Summoner's Court thought that if you couldn't beat me, you wouldn't be enough of a challenge.
Chin up, Leander. Keep practicing and you'll get better.
I suppose you're right. I'll let the others know that your mettle's been tested and that you passed.
Revelio. Scrope? Who is Scrope? Revelio. 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 Pumpkins. Oh, I think I know just the place. Revelio. Revelio. Avelio. Edge. This had better not be a trick.
Thank you for coming all this way. The name's Scrope. Scrope serves the headmaster. Been in the Black family for years. Apologies for the abundance of notes. Scrope wanted to be sure you weren't followed.
What's this all about? Your notes mentioned the book I found in the restricted section.
Scrope can tell you more in exchange for your help, but no one, especially the headmaster, can know.
Happy to help, especially if you can shed light on the book.
Scrope is grateful. Scrope's late mistress, Apollonia Black, may she rest in peace, was a student at Hogwarts over 50 years ago. Before she died, she spoke with passion of pages ripped from a book. Scrope suspects she took them to her private grotto. She was delirious at the end, poor thing. Mistook Belladonna for elderberries. Scrope tried to warn her.
I'm sorry to hear that, but how do you benefit if I find the pages?
Scrope believes that a treasured Black family ring is also in the grotto. Scrope wishes to give it to the headmaster. Apollonia forbade Scrope from entering the grotto long ago. Scrope continues to honor her wishes. Scrope would not dare ask a student for help, but when Scrope learned you were looking for those pages, Scrope thought you might also find the ring.
How did you know that I'd found a book, and that it's missing pages?
Scrope and the other house elves are good at staying out of sight. Scrope hears and sees many things in the castle. Scrope knows how to keep secrets.
It seems this may help us both. I shall do it.
Scrope is relieved. Scrope hoped the young Slytherin would be willing to help. Take this toast to the grotto just down the coast. Place it on the pedestal there. Good luck. Scrope will wait right here for you. Best of luck finding your pages. And the ring.
Revelio. I need a piece of toast. I suppose that's where it goes.
Could it be a visitor?
Oh!
Ah! Ooh!
Ah! The name's Richard Jackdaw. I was a student, just like you, about a century ago. How in the world did you find this place?
A house elf named Scrope sent me. Said I might find a black family ring here.
Ah. Sorry to say, I sold the ring a long time ago. Poor Scrope. Still holds a candle for Apollonia, I reckon. Can't say I blame him. I stole all these treasures just to impress her. Alas, 'twas to no avail. I thought a secret map I pilfered from Peeves would pique her interest. But she simply rolled her eyes. What would I want with yellowed old pages torn from a book? Not my finest moment.
I'd like to have those pages, if you don't mind.
They're not here. I thought if Apollonia wasn't interested in the map on the pages, perhaps it would lead to something that would intrigue her. So, I followed the map to what I can only describe as an enchanted cave of some kind. And you see what happened next. Here's an idea. Why don't you meet me at the edge of the Forbidden Forest, and I'll show you where to find the pages.
I suppose if that's the only way for me to get those pages, I'll meet you at the forest.
I'm sure the pages are still tucked in my waistcoat. If you don't mind the sight of a, well, my decapitated skeleton, they're yours for the taking.
Doesn't appear to be connected to the missing pages. Best hang on to it for now. Revelio. Hello, Scrope. Thanks to you, I was able to enter Apollina's grotto. The toast was the key. I met a ghost there, Richard Jackdaw, who's agreed to lead me to the pages I've been looking for.
Phew. That boy was never good enough for Apollonia. Oh, what of the Black Family Ring?
I'm sorry to say that Jackdaw sold it long ago.
Sad news indeed. Scrope shall need to think of another way to impress the headmaster. Scrope takes some consolation in knowing that the young Slytherin found what they needed.
I did. Thank you again, Scrope. You're a credit to House Elves. Revelio. Lumos. Hello, Mr. Semi.
What can I do for you?
What do you have for sale?
What can I help you with today? Aren't you the student who ran all those goblin loyalists off? I hope to see you again sometime.
Imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented blue powder.
Lumos. Enchanted candles. Wonder where they're heading. candles seem to be leading into the Forbidden Forest. Treasure must be nearby. I suppose the picnic in the Forbidden Forest could seem romantic to some. Treasure hunting suits me. Lumos.
sending... Lumos.
She couldn't do it. Didn't work.
Revelio. Lumos. Revelio.
Here I am, as good as my word.
We meet again, Richard Jackdaw.
I suppose I shouldn't be surprised to see you. It took the cunning of a Slytherin to track down these pages.
Well said. Now where do we go from here?
Follow me. I shall lead you as far as I can, but I fear I may remain a tad reluctant to revisit the scene of my demise. Keep your eyes open for a birdbath. When you find it, say Intramuros. I think it's Latin. Or Greek. As you can imagine, I never paid much attention in school. Shall we?
Aside from the bird bath, anything else I should look for?
Indeed. A few landmarks. A stone bridge, a waterfall.
Lumos.
And, if I recall, a lake. You'll see.
You've been very helpful. Thank you.
Surprising how much of this is... rather unfortunately coming back to me. Yes. You know, the closer we get, the more I'm remembering. Probably best I leave you to it. Simply stick to the path and keep a sharp eye out for that birdbath. Adieu. Is that Latin? Or Greek?
Thank you.
rebellion. Incendio! Revelio! Incendio!
You've had too much firewood. Irondale's not half as covered as there.
The waterfall. For a thief, Jackdaw's surprisingly as good as his word.
Revelio!
Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Oddly solemn about this place. Such regal creatures, stags. There it is, just as Jackdaw described.
Revelio!
Intramuros. Lumos.
Aren't you a little far from home?
Renrock knew you'd eventually lead us to whatever it is you're hiding. But,
those loyalists will report back to Ranrock now. Let's see where Jackdaw has led me. I wonder how big this place is.
Revelio.
It doesn't stay lit for long. I need to light all three before they time out on me. Someone didn't want casual visitors down here.
Revelio!
I wonder if the smells will help me through this.
Thank you.
not going to touch those. platform ought to be able to float straight to me. Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but where could he be? Jackdaw wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave. Revelio. Another puzzle. Well, if Jackdaw could solve this, so can I. That's odd. I'd have thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot, but there's no sign of him. It's a good thing Jackdaw didn't fall down there. Here. Revelio. Not a headless skeleton in sight, but I may as well help myself to this. An untouched chest. Jackdaw wasn't very thorough in his search for the thief. Rebellion. There it is. It's almost complete. More spiders! This could be what they're probably doing. Revelio. I'd have thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot. There's no sign of him. I'll need to look around for the symbol.
Revelio!
I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but where could he be?
Revelio.
An untouched chest. Jackdaw wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave. I must be getting closer to Jackdaw's remains. And those pages. Revelio. We meet again, Richard Jackdaw. Thank you for keeping these pages safe all these years. Here it is. The map that brought your doom, Jackdaw. Is there something beyond this room? Starting to flood. How am I being protected? What sort of magic is this? I can only hope this magic protects me until I'm able to make my way out of here. What is this place? Revelio!
can it be?
Revelio. It's you.
Has someone finally found our map chamber?
I recognize you from the Pensives. You're Professor Rackham.
I am indeed. I must confess that I am surprised to see someone so young standing before me.
I'm the same age that you and Isadora Morganarch were when you started at Hogwarts.
You've paid attention. And might I presume you share our ability?
To see traces of ancient magic? Yes, sir, I do.
As you have likely realized by now, our ability gives us a unique relationship with all forms of magic. We can access expressions of magic that few others can. Opportunities will arise that allow you to sharpen this rare talent. Do not squander them.
I won't, Professor. Thank you.
We have much to discuss. But first, a map found in a certain book led you here. Place the book on the pedestal.
I don't have the book with me, sir.
That is unfortunate. I'm afraid we must pause our conversation until you return with the book.
Very well. I'll retrieve the book right away.
Good. We shall speak again once the book is in place.
Thank you.